Finally got to meet him. But look, it's a nice view. Heading towards Cucamonga Peak. Just got done packing out of Ice House Saddle. Keep moving forward. Yeah, all the cars that were there. Probably at the peak. Yeah.
There's a great campground to make a left when you go up to the first view with your finger. And then there's a little tiny tree. You use the trail and going back to that trail and see a bunch of other trails and goes out to the ledge. There's a bunch of campgrounds.
Seven in the morning too.
That's a big one. Two guys.
Yeah.
That one video cracked me up, that time where you scared those hikers.
That one guy was gonna jump, man.
Really?
Yeah. The other guy jumped, what the fuck are you doing? You know, it's a guy, it's not a bear. He was gonna jump up. Near the end, he's like looking down like, where did he jump down to?
Damn, that was crazy.
That's hilarious. I started cracking up. I couldn't stop laughing when I seen that video. You must have got, what, like 10 people or something?
That one group, just the whole group, man, they turn around and run.
Check it out, the mine. Which mine is this?
I'm not sure what the name of it is. Or if it has one, but it's an old gold mine.
It's awesome. Bear or lion. That's cool. First actual mine I've come across too.
Leftover cables where they used to run some stuff down.
Yeah. That's awesome. Shoot, that's a good shelter in there.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. We could sleep in it. It would rain too hard.
But it would be easy, you know? Yeah.
Look at that. It's a big tree.
It is. It's a big slingshot. Sasquatch slingshot.
be throwing these massive pine cones at people.
Oh, Frank tells me this story. I believe he's too good. My friend doesn't lie up there. He was up in Ventura, I think he said, one time. He was a teenager.
Yeah.
19, maybe 18, 19. He used to live up there. And he said, he played something to do. He did crowd spot. How did he No. And then he went way back. The entire day, walking back, following his creek. So fish in a secret spot. Did real good. Had the fish with them. They were going to cook it, find a place to camp, but he just kept following the river, up river, up river. He goes, they were back there the entire day.
Wow.
Walking, you know. Probably 15, 20 miles in, maybe. 10 or 15 miles in. And, he set up camp. Because we heard something in the cliffs above, but we figured it was going on. Because we set up camp, put our tent up, got our fire going, we took our trout, and he goes, rock, he's pointing at something. There's rocks about this size. Started pointing down to the top and splashing in the stream by.
Huh.
He goes, who the fuck's up there? We're yelling, who's up there? And he goes, pulled out a 22. If you don't stop, we're going to get shot. Kept going. He shot. He goes, the rock just shot. He goes, but then in the middle of the night, he goes, big one. Oh, I just started coming down.
Shh.
He goes, there's no rock coming. He goes, there's no trail there. He goes, there's no way anything's going to climb the cliff. It's a couple hundred feet up. It's pure rock.
Yeah.
He goes, who the fuck is it? He goes, my buddy said, he thinks it was a Sasquatch. Yeah, that's what excited me in the 60s and 70s.
Wow.
So, he goes, we just rode it off and the weird happened. He goes, a year and a half later, we went back there again. Same spot. And he goes, same shit happened.
Really?
He goes, what are the chances that the two got the both times again? He goes, so we call that Sasquatch thing. He goes, I've never been back since. He goes, my brother says, we'll never go back.
Wow. That is crazy.
Big rock. The rocks are falling down on these 50 pounds. And they're falling down all the way.
Wow.
Because when they hit the ground, you could feel.
The feel shake.
The yeah. And there's no ground or anything.
Just rock throwing.
No rock throwing. Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah. That's a trip. That's meant then.
One time, he went back down with his dude. His sister's boyfriend, his sister's boyfriend said that he was, one corner anomaly in the second one.
Right.
So, his sister was hitting everything, and he was, I don't keep a pin. He dug a hole in the ground, he left some wood, and he made a coal bed, and let the coals going, growing. He was, he was going to take his shoes off and try to walk on it. He was, but then he buried it.
Check it out, guys. Look at that. Wow. It's beautiful. That's where I'm at. That's where I live, in that area. Engulfed in clouds. This whole area except us. We're above them. It's pretty nice. Victorville, Phelan, Hesperia, Wrightwood area, all that down there. It's beautiful. And I'm up here. I think I see Quartzsite. Not too sure. But yeah, we're heading towards the Cucamonga Peak. Almost there. Probably like a mile and a half left. That's cool. Okay. Cool.
Star Wars. Oh, Lando Calrissian.
Is that who I look like? There's another backpacker down there. Look at this view. Almost at the peak. Mount Baldy, Baldy boy, devil is back. And that's a view. We're almost at the summit now. Just a couple, few more switchbacks. We get this whole view to ourselves. Well, and some other dude up there. Look at that. Is it open year round?
Yes.
Yeah? That's cool. Do they?
Where you can pay a little bit. Maybe $30. You get in this group, you hike to the top, and they lay out a big old spread of food and drink.
Oh.
And they all sit there, eat and drink whatever you want.
Tell stories and just have a good time, huh?
Yeah.
Ah, I need to do that.